you develop these things while food is available, we're eating everything comfortably, then at the time of non-availability you can maintain. You cannot learn things at the time of non-availability of food or with appetite. So that is the problem. One is Anna Lakshana, second is Anna Dravya Vijnana. That deals with the ingredients of food. Third thing is Anna Adhikara, eligibility or qualifications for the eaters. We are very much seeing about the quality of the food only, not about the eaters. So what are the different types of members of the society? Are they body oriented, are they mind oriented, intellect oriented, or spiritual oriented? Based on that, this type of food classification should be made. A bodybuilder or a muscular mountain, he may require a different type of food. He is not bothered about the mental sturdity or intellect. So that cannot be imitated by a person who is a seeker of mental peace. So adhikara, that is differentiated from a person and his purpose. If you want spiritual benefits, then you have to take such foods which are very much for that. It is like a prasuti niyama. If somebody is pregnant, they won't bother about what they like or what it is available, what is in abundant, what is cheap. They won't bother about like things. Whatever that is salubrious to the development of the embryo, whatever that facilitates a safer growth as well as a safer delivery of the child, they will concentrate only on that. Likewise, if we are having Brahman inside, if our heart is pregnant with the Brahma Tattva, like we are pregnant in the embryo with the Shishu Tattva, we are also having the pregnancy inside. That is known as Krit Garbha in the Vedas. So we realize that we are also having somebody inside, and accordingly we have to consume our food and restrict our desires and attune our pathway of life of not only food consumption, which will decide each and every moment and behavioral extension of our life. So that is very much essential. Anna Adhikara Nirnaya. Anna Bheda. Even in these things there are varieties of foods. Ingredients are having innumerable varieties. Permutations are, the thousands of permutations have been invented. Especially India's innovative temper and scientific development is more in cookery. How many variety of dishes? Now everybody is in competition. Everybody is developing their own Italian cuisine, then Chinese. Everybody is in competition. But we have got lot of combinations. There are few criticizers which are not known to people, which are based on cookery as per the person's Rashi, Nakshatra and Mandala. Yes, it is astro cookery. If a person's kundali naturally says that a person is pertaining to Pitta, Vata, Kapha, or this age he may be having diabetes, this age he may be having some degradation, by knowing a person's physical superstructure as well as inner structure, designing the food model as per the seasons, designing the food model as per the availability of grains, designing special models as per the speciality of occasions, designing things as per the constitution and configuration of people. These four types of designs are there in Anga Vibheda or Anna Vibheda Lakshana. These are known as four Angas, different Anga Vibheda. And these four things are to be maintained. One is based on astrology, second is based on physical constitution. The mother knows what is acceptable, what is allergic, energetic and synergetic to the child, can be understood by a child, mother. So that is also a constitutional feeding or configurative understanding feeding that is also done by people. Apart from that, I have given four major schools of thought. Then Anna Parishkara, we are getting something from Mother Earth. We have to repay our gratitude to earth, to water, to soil, to the food grains who are there in the form of vanaspati, to the god, to the flowers, to the bullock, to the cow. Every unit of this thing, we have to respond with gratitude. And that must be something ritualistic and symbolic. Daily, if a person after eating is searching for the farmer, plow, then ox, bullock, cart, mother earth, if he is doing that, he cannot do any other work except eating and paying gratitude in his life. So, a symbolic and composite representation of all gratitude which is given or which is submitted in a common reservoir, either in a mula tattva, that is a primordial force which governs everything. It may be a bullock, it may be a cow, it may be a plough, it may be land, it may be water, it may be soil, it may be the minerals and the nutritional contents of the soil, it may be the bija, the seeds, whatever it may be, everything is having two things. One is a common reservoir which is known as gati, and a common pool or a common origination which is known as agati. Where it has come from is known as agati. Where everything is going to end is known as gati. So we are taking, our religion has taken a riskless and a tiresome free methodology of looking for the agati and gati for all of these innumerable ingredients by which we can comfortably pay our gratitudes. It is known as Anna Parishkara. How to do three things. One is purification of food. Second thing is vitalization of food. Third thing is sanctification of food. Purification of food is done by two things. One is by gratitude, second is by distribution. It should be given to the right people. Elders in our house, they are the right people. And those who are physically weak, they are the right people. And those who are growing, those people are to be preferred. So, to give priority to the growing people, our well-grown and tottering, ripen old age people, and to the Pitrus, to our ancestors, to the God, and as our Manasa Samarpana, we have to offer it to each and every unit of nature. And it is not going to take any time, or you are not going to really share with God. If God really consumes the food, nobody will offer food to God at all. So, it is a procedure by which Anna is purified. You have to give it to the unseen forces, seen forces but distant forces, and proximate forces. Proximate forces are your family members, seniors, worshipable people, guests and everybody. Distant forces are the plough, farmer, everybody, I have already told. That is by manasik, by our mind. Third thing is to the God, the primordial force, we have to do that. Unless these things are done, this gratitude and distribution is maintained, food is impure. That's why Veda say, kevala gho bhavati kevala di, says the Veda. Any person eating alone, he eats only sin, and that is not food. Why?
Right? Let's see.
Great clapping. So this is Anna Parishkara. Second thing is vitalization of our food. How is vitalization of our food possible? By means of Pariveshana. We are doing a lot of exercises at the time of eating food. Abhojana, Pariveshana, then Antaprana Samarpana, Antar Balidana, Pranahuti, Pancha Pranahuti. By doing these exercises, these rituals, food is vitalized. Number two, even without rituals, a person having proper work, proper determination, free of evil thought, is more powerful to consume less food and to get more energy. So this is vitalization of food. And sanctification of food is done by a person's celibacy, austerity and other spiritual way of life. So by mere gratitude and distribution, it is purified. By means of physical exercises like work, rest, service, etc., as well as by means of ritualistic exercise like Panchapranahuti, etc., food is vitalized. And when a person leads a spiritual design of life, the same food is sanctified. It can give you knowledge, it can give you mental comfort, it can give you liberation, it can give everything whatever you want without the need of any other tool except the food. That is the greatness of food. Then we are coming into Anna Vidhi and Anna Gati. What is Anna Vidhi? Kala Vidhi. Dik Vidhi. Krama Vidhi, Dravya Vidhi, and Upadhana Vidhi. Kala Vidhi means when to eat the food. If the food is not taken, we may have a lot of excuses. We are traveling and we are working. In Apadharma, it is okay. Apadharma means it is somewhere very exceptionally done. Every time whenever we come to school late, we have to purchase a national flag for 2 rupees. When we are studying 7th or 8th standard. And that is not a special honor or merit or a very great national patriotic offer.